This video is part of a miniseries on how to easily set up fully functioning FoundryVTT on our Raspberry Pi. By now, we already have working FoundryVTT in our home environment, and now we are going to up our game by using Nginx as reverse proxy server, and we will use Cloudflare and Certbot to secure connections to our FoundryVTT. Hope it helps. Hi there, it's Vee from Helping Ninja. If you're here for the first time, it could be useful for you to check my prior videos to this one. It will all make a little bit more sense. We are in the process of building FoundryVTT server brick by brick, and we're nearing the point where we can say we can start safely playing with it. In this video, we are about to do a little dive into Nginx, Cloudflare and Certbot. Interested? Let's dive into it.
Okay, so we're freshly logged in our Raspberry. I've got this habit of checking if everything is up to date, so let me just quickly make this sudo apt update and upgrade. Fine, so what we'll try to accomplish here is we'll install Nginx as reverse proxy and point traffic to our Foundry server. Then we'll do a little bit of configuration of FoundryVTT itself. And we'll use Certbot in cooperation with Nginx and Cloudflare to make connections to our server secured with SSL. First thing we need to do is install Nginx on our server. Sudo apt install Nginx. Clear the screen. Once it's installed, we'll create configuration file for our domain. In my case, it's helping.ninja domain. So by convention, create similar file like I do. Sudo vim etc nginx sites available helping.ninja.conf. Obviously use your domain here and put in something like this inside. You will find link to these text contents in the description below. And that's basically enough for now. You don't need to understand everything in it. Just make sure to look through it and replace your Foundry and your domain with your actual domain and subdomain names. Save the file and exit the editor. Once this is done, let's head to Foundry options file, open this file, share Foundry data config options JSON, and change these lines: hostname to your actual domain name on which you want to run your Foundry server. In my case, it's rdnd helping.ninja. Proxy SSL set to true, proxy port set to HTTPS, so 443, save and exit the file. One thing to mention here before we proceed, you need to have ports 80 and 443 forwarded to your Raspberry Pi in your home network setup, so that the request from outer internet can get to your Raspberry. But there are so many possible network configurations, I won't even try to dig into it here. Try to figure it out on your own, or ask a tech-savvy friend, or drop a call for help here in the comment section. Maybe I or someone else would be able to point you in the right direction. So now, let me take you to Cloudflare, which I use as DNS provider. Its DNS service is free and secure. Add your domain here or use your favorite DNS provider, but for the sake of this tutorial, I'll assume that you are using Cloudflare as I am. So we'll go into our domain configuration. I'll assume your DNS is already pointing to your Raspberry Pi. And what we need to do here, we want to create a token which we will use to edit DNS zone in Cloudflare. Scroll a little bit down and click get your API token. You can see I've already created one token, but don't let this confuse you. Just hit create token and use template named edit zone DNS. Check the permissions. It needs to be zone DNS edit and limit the token to this domain. Include specific zone, your domain. If you want more security, you can specify from which IP addresses this token can be used. I'll just leave it empty for now. You hit continue to the summary. I'll just cancel this token creation process as I already have one token, as you have seen before. Don't forget to copy your token somewhere safe so we can use it later on. As a next step, we're going to create .secrets folder in our home directory. Make dir .secrets, cd secrets, make dir certbot, cd certbot. And here we are going to create file named cloudflare.ini in which we'll save our Cloudflare API token. Paste here, Cloudflare API token used by certbot, DNS Cloudflare API token. Of course, replace this string with your actual API token from Cloudflare. Save and exit. Clear the screen. Next thing we're going to do is install certbot. To do that, we need to install snapd. It's software packaging system developed by Canonical. Sudo apt install snapd. Okay, now we're going to use snap to install core package. Sudo snap install core, sudo snap refresh core is command for updating, but there is of course no update as we just installed this core package. Now to the point, install certbot with this command, sudo snap install classic certbot. This classic flag gives the certbot snap more permissions that it needs to function properly. Let's create a symbolic link to certbot binary so we can call it directly. Sudo ln-s snap bin certbot user bin certbot. Okay. Run this command to acknowledge that the installed plugin will have the same classic containment as the certbot snap. Sudo snap set certbot trust plugin with root. Okay. And of course, we want to make our life simpler, so we want to enable certbot to work directly with Cloudflare DNS service. We're going to install one more plugin, sudo snap install certbot DNS Cloudflare. And hopefully, we are ready to make certbot take care of our Nginx's HTTPS or SSL configuration. Certbot-i, Nginx, DNS, Cloudflare, and so on and so on. I stands for installer for Nginx, that's simple. DNS Cloudflare, again, that's obvious, we want to use Cloudflare's DNS service. And DNS Cloudflare credentials point to the Cloudflare token we've created for our domain. And the -d sets domain names for which we want to create our SSL certificate. So hit enter, and of course I forgot to use sudo. Let's try again. Let me enter my email address here. Of course I've read your terms of service. Yes. Yes, of course you can send me email. This red message right here tells me I haven't set correct permissions for the file in which I stored my Cloudflare API token. Good to know, we can fix that later. Damn, this doesn't look right. I've forgotten to enable my site in Nginx configuration. We all do mistakes, I guess. Let me fix this real quick. We'll create symbolic link from sites enabled to sites available in Nginx configuration. So sudo lns and etc nginx sites available helping ninja conf. Etc nginx sites enabled helping ninja conf. And run the certbot again. So I choose reinstalling the already created certificate from my last try. And now this looks correct. I need to choose for which servers I want to use this certificate. I choose 1 and 2 because I want to use it for my main domain and all subdomains, and specifically for my RDND subdomain. And I don't want to use it for the default server under number 3. Which blocks do I want to modify? Let's modify only configuration in our created file, so 1. Great, we see the congratulations message. We successfully enabled HTTPS on our Foundry server. Clear the screen. Let me just quickly show you what happened automatically. Sudo vim etc nginx sites enabled helping ninja conf. Everything that was touched by certbot has this hashtag managed by certbot message at the end. You can go through it if you want to. To be on the safe side, let us just check the nginx configuration file if it's okay. Sudo nginx-t. Your syntax is okay and the test was successful. so we can reload Nginx with our new configuration. Sudo service Nginx reload. One thing to say before we get to our grand finale is that if you're trying to connect to your Foundry from inside your home network, you need to set your DNS right and point your domain to your Raspberry Pi in your home network. I've done this on my home router. I've set my subdomain rdnd helping ninja to point to the correct IP address of my Pi. That's it. Let's head to our browser and put in our domain name. In my case, rdnd helping.ninja, and bam, everything works. You see it was redirected to HTTPS. And this padlock icon means our web page is using our new certificate verified by Let's Encrypt Authority. And that's exactly what we were shooting for in this tutorial. Happy foundering!
Thanks for watching. I hope this tutorial helped you. Please consider hitting that subscribe button. It means a lot to me. Take care.